What up, Roomie? I told you I got you.
Resolution Sports, the number one source, breaking from football up to extreme sports. So come on and join the resolution. Join the resolution.
Checking in here with Delen, Sniper Parsley, just picked up his ninth professional win, now 9-0 as a professional. Look sharp, look clean out there. How'd you feel tonight, Delen?
I felt good. I felt strong. It's my first time at 160, so it was a new weight. I fought a real tough kid, you know what I mean? He was 10-7, but he's been in there with some real good fighters. So I feel like it was a test. It was a push. You know, they got a lot of headbutts in there. That's what threw me off. But the Southpaw orthodox, it happens all the time. It's part of the game. So I had to fight through it. But all in all, I felt I had a good performance. Could have been a little sharper, more devastating. But it'll just come along with the experience and getting adjusted to fighting at 160.
Absolutely. And now you did a real nice job using that range, Lynn, used that jab, and then you set up with that right hook, you know, when you found your openings and everything. Now, how'd you kind of plan? You know, it's going to be difficult when a southpaw fights orthodox. What are some of the most important things going into a fight, you know, where some of those things are going to occur that would only happen between, you know, two opposite fights?
Fighters. You know what I mean? Focus on, you know what I mean, the basics we work on in the gym, keeping our foot on the outside of his. Just boxing. I mean, I don't want to get an exchange match with a southpaw because it's coming from a crazy angle due to the headbutt. It was hard for me to see from that side, so I just did what I'm good at. I boxed my way to a victory. You know what I mean? Important spots that I shouldn't have, but all in all, I boxed. I stuck with my game plan, didn't get, you know what I mean, frazzled in there, so I just stayed behind my jab and boxed my way to another victory.
And you caught the headbutt rather early in the fight. You know, of course, that's going to cause an adjustment that you don't necessarily go through in training. What are some of the key things, you know, once you caught that headbutt and you knew it'd be a little bit of an issue? You know, how do you kind of get past that and, you know, overlook it?
Suck it up. You're in a pain game. So I just had to suck it up, bite down. My trainers in my ear let me know I was all right. So as long as my corner says I'm all right, I'm always there to fight. I'm always ready to fight. So I just went there for it. Sometimes you got to do what you got to do. You got to bite down. Get through it and show some grit. I'm a fighter, so I gotta fight.
No doubt, no doubt. And like you said, it's your first fight at 160. You know, how was the training going leading into this fight, you know, to get yourself used to the new weight? And then tonight, how was it fighting at the new weight?
Oh, the training was excellent. I had a real long camp. I had a three-month camp. It was real good. I sparred some strong southpaws, some good fighters. But it's a different feeling than being in the ring with 10-ounce gloves with a natural 160-pounder that's bigger. He's used to being at that weight. But all in all, it was good. My power was there. My tolerance for his power was there. He was a strong fighter, but I've been hit harder in sparring. So it was just more about don't get in there, get into the crowd with the oohs and the ahs, just stay focused, stay on my game plan, just listen to my team, and it guided me to my ninth victory like they always
do. It could definitely tell you felt strong out there at the weight. So it was, you know, of course, seen by all of us outside the ropes as well. And, you know, something you were talking about earlier, Delen, you know, 10-7 might have been King's record, but he's a much better fighter than that record shows. Almost every fight he's been in there with was undefeated, one loss. You know, he's really been in there, you know, with some scrappy cats. You know, how much did you know about him coming into this fight in particular?
I just knew he fought a lot of dudes that I was around in the amateurs that were good fighters. Jay Leon Love, you know, a lot of dudes that were up and coming, that were undefeated, that still up there right now in my weight. So they just fought a lot of good people, but he's never fought me, so until he's gotten it with me, I can't really judge it. I don't really watch video because he could have fought that man this way, fought me this way. But he came in there to fight. I feel he came prepared. I came prepared. I was just a better man than that.
And to close us out, Delen, you're now 9-0. I know that 10-0 is looking good to you, that double digit. What do you think we can expect you back in the ring? And, you know, what's to be expected from you the rest of this year and then heading into 2013?
I expect to get in the ring probably before New Year's. No rush. You know what I mean? It's a new way we're making smart strategic moves. But y'all can expect to see I'm stronger now, so y'all can expect to see a stronger fighter, a solid fighter. Only got two knockouts, but they're coming. More coming. As we get adjusted to this weight, we feeling stronger. We sitting down, our punches coming. I'm developing as a fighter, so every fight, it's that I move on better and better every fight. I can only get better. I can't get worse.
Getting better and involved in every fight. It's the name of the game right there, Delen. But like I said earlier, Delen did a fantastic job out there. Looked smooth, looked clean, and definitely used all your tools out there. Want to thank you for stepping in here for a few minutes with us. And as always, it's been so great to us at Resolution Sports. And we definitely appreciate that from you.
No problem. I thank Resolution Sports for following me all this long, sticking behind me. I appreciate you guys.
And we staying with you.
Thank you.
All right, Delen. And we going.